Today, we will discuss geologic time or deep time. What is your view of time? Is it linear or cyclical? Most people in the U.S. think of time as linear, but other societies view it as circular. In geology, we consider both relative and absolute time. Relative time and relative dating is based on principles such as the principle of original horizontality. And that principle is that sedimentary rocks are laid down more or less horizontally, and the younger ones are on top. You also need to think about if the rock record, that record of sedimentary rocks, whether it's complete or not, is something missing. Think about the external and the internal processes that we have discussed earlier. Internal processes build up mountains, but those external processes wear them down. They can erode the mountains. If they erode the mountains, they can produce something called an unconformity, where you have no deposition and it represents missing time. We will see examples of this on our field trip. Also, absolute dating. For example, how old is the Earth? There have been many ideas about this. For example, the Greeks in 450 BC determined that the Earth was thousands of years old by looking at the flood layers on the Nile River Delta. Very logical approach for that time. In the 1860s, Lord Kelvin interpreted that the Earth formed between 20 and 40 million years ago based on how long it would take for the Earth to cool from a molten state at the beginning. Also, a very logical approach for that time. Many geologists and biologists in the 1800s, for example, thought that the age of less than 100 million years was too low based on the rock cycle, which we've discussed before. They thought we needed more time for the rock cycle to take place and for evolution to take place. Two geologists, Lyell and Hutton, were the first major proponents of this idea. It was because of them that we eventually resulted in the idea of deep time. We now know that the Earth is 4.5 billion years old. Why do we know this? It's based on radioactive decay. Radioactivity was discovered in the late 1800s, and we realized that it released heat. So Kelvin's calculations based on originally molten Earth were too low because heat has been added since the Earth formed from radioactive decay. We also discovered that radioactive decay was regular and constant, and it produced what's called a half-life. This was used to determine the age of rocks in the early 1900s. They used minerals like uranium and uranium age dating.
The oldest rocks on the Earth are a little over 4 billion years old.
That's actually a minimum age. We think the Earth was 4.5 billion years old, and that comes from dating of meteorites, which we think formed at the same time as the Earth. You should learn more about radioactive decay in the reading and other material for the class. 4.5 billion years is a long time. It's deep time. It's very hard to imagine. Think of a football field. You're up in the stands and you're looking at the field. It's 100 yards. Where does all of human history fit on that field? Well, if you have one goal line, the beginning of the Earth, and today is the other goal line, all of human history is less than an inch, less than the width of one of those goal lines.